The motivation for the book was very definitely to present an alternative history to the Vietnam War, because the way the Vietnam War is understood in the United States is that it's an American war. The Americans are concerned about what the war did to them and not really to the Vietnamese. And of course, that's personally very important to me because I'm an American. But I think it's also globally important because the way that the rest of the world understands the Vietnam War is through the American perspective. And I felt that writing this novel would give me an opportunity to intervene in the way that Americans remember this war, and therefore in the way that the rest of the world remembers this war as well. The writer is very definitely a spy in the family, a spy in the house, a spy in the country. And that's why anybody who talks to a writer should be very careful about what they say, because writers, or at least me, we're always listening to what people are saying. We're always observing what people are doing. And I think it's necessary for writers to be spies in order for them to understand how human beings work, how societies work, because our job is to be able to look at these societies and these people in a way that they themselves can't see themselves. And in order to do that, we have to hide some part of ourselves when we interact with other people, so that we can elicit things from them that they would only say when their guard is down. Graham Greene is certainly one of the more important literary influences that I've had. I've read him since I was young, and in particular, of course, he wrote The Quiet American, which many people consider to be one of the classic accounts of the Vietnam War. And I was so annoyed by that book that I wrote one of my theses in college criticizing The Quiet American. And when it came time to writing The Sympathizer, I wanted to respond to Graham Greene because of his influence on the way that the world remembers the Vietnam War. And there were a number of other major writers that were important to me. Obviously, Ralph Ellison from the United States and his novel Invisible Man is a novel that I cite from the very beginning of The Sympathizer. And here in France, Céline's Journey to the End of the Night was a novel that I read in preparation for The Sympathizer. And it was very influential for me because of Céline's ambition in terms of how much history he was covering in that particular book. I think America, the United States of America, and American artists probably will not finish with the Vietnam War so long as the United States itself doesn't change. And that's because in the same way that the United States is still dealing with the histories of slavery and the Civil War and genocide and racism, all of these problems are perpetually important in American society because they come from the very heart of American society. These are deep-seated problems that we haven't been able to overcome. And likewise, the Vietnam War comes from the problem that the United States has in terms of always waging war. It just happens to be the most graphic war, the most controversial war in our history besides the Civil War. So as long as the United States remains a military-industrial complex that is trying to exert its power all over the world, the Vietnam War will remain a very torturous subject for the United States.